Hello, welcome everybody. This is Dr. Bolad, board certified physician in cardiology, interventional cardiology, and internal medicine. I'm here to help you with all the information you need for your heart health and medical health and informing you about all the latest treatments in medicine and cardiology. If you are new to this channel, then definitely consider hitting the subscribe button below and switch on the notification bell so you don't miss any new videos that I post. Today, I will talk to you about the coronavirus COVID-19 vaccines, short-term side effects. The long-term side effects are unknown, as the vaccines were developed very recently in less than 1 year, and individuals have only recently started receiving them. Currently, in the United States, there are two vaccines that are approved by the Food and Drug Administration, the FDA, under the Emergency Use Authorization. These two vaccines use the same technology in their development, known as messenger RNA technology, abbreviated as mRNA. The first vaccine is the Pfizer-BioNTech COVID-19 vaccine. This vaccine comes stored in ultra-low temperature freezers between minus 80 degrees to minus 6 degrees centigrade, equivalent to minus 112 to minus 76 Fahrenheit, and protected from light. Before it's used, it's thawed and then stored undiluted in refrigerators in temperature 2 to 8 degrees centigrade. Before injection, it must be diluted using 1.8 ml of sodium chloride. The vaccine is given by intramuscular injection administered as a series of two doses, 0.3 ml, 3 weeks apart. The second vaccine is the Moderna COVID-19 vaccine. This vaccine is a white to off-white sterile, preservative-free frozen suspension for intramuscular injection. The vaccine is provided as a frozen suspension stored between minus 25 to minus 15 centigrade in multi-dose vials containing 10 doses. The vaccines must be thawed prior to administration. After thawing, a maximum of 10 doses, each 0.5 ml, can be withdrawn from each vial. Files can be stored in the refrigerator in 2 to 8 degrees for up to 30 days prior to use. The vaccine is administered intramuscularly in two doses, 4 weeks apart, each 0.5 ml. The adverse events reported to occur from using these two vaccines are similar, which is understandable given that these two vaccines use the same technology. The adverse events that I will talk to you about were obtained from information provided by these two companies on their application for approval by the Food and Drug Administration in the United States and from data published in scientific journals. I will talk about the adverse reactions based on their frequency. Adverse reactions occurring in more than 10% of vaccinated individuals. These include local pain at the injection site occurring in 66 to 83% of vaccinated individuals. Fatigue occurs in 34 to 59% of vaccinated individuals and is more common after the second dose. Headache occurs in 25 to 55% of individuals who have been vaccinated and is also commoner after the second dose. Chills occur in 6 to 35% of individuals and is higher in individuals after the second dose. Joint aches occur in 9 to 22% of individuals and is also commoner after the second dose. Muscle aches occur in 14 to 37% of vaccinated individuals, also commoner after the second dose. Diarrhea occurs in 8% to 11% of vaccinated individuals, commoner also after the second dose. Fever occurs in 1% to 16% of vaccinated individuals. Adverse reactions occurring in between 1 to 10% of vaccinated individuals include local injection site redness occurring in 5-7% of vaccinated individuals. Local swelling at the injection site occurring in 6-8% of vaccinated individuals. Nausea and vomiting occurring in 1-12% of vaccinated individuals. Adverse reactions occurring in less than 1% of vaccinated individuals, and these are not clearly related to the vaccine, and they include enlarged lymph nodes, inflamed appendix, medically known as appendicitis, Bell's palsy, in which the muscles of either the right side or the left side of the face become paralyzed, as seen on this picture. When the lady tries to close her eyes, the face muscles on the left side of the screen are working normally, while the muscles on the right side of the screen are paralyzed and are not functioning properly, not allowing her to close her eyes. It is not known at this time whether this complication occurs with increased incidence with the coronavirus vaccination. If you have any question about what I presented to you today or any medical question in general, then subscribe to my channel and share your question in the comments section below and I will reply to you. If you have a question that you would not like to share in public, then subscribe to this channel, follow me on Twitter at Dr. Bolad, and then send me a private Twitter direct message and I will reply to you. Please like and share this video with family and friends. This is Dr. Bolad helping you with your heart health and medical health. Thanks for watching and talk to you soon.